They are in the hawkish camp, along with the Canada and the UK. And I think, you know, today's meeting validates the market's expectation of a hawkish, of further hawkishness to come, given that we are seeing a strong recovery in the economy. The Kiwi is also benefiting from high commodity prices. And along with that, we have a housing market in New Zealand that's on fire. So I think all these are supportive of eventual rate hike, perhaps later this year. And I do see further room for recovery of the Kiwi dollar.
So by the end of the year, where do you see the Kiwi dollar?
By the end of the year, I think we could possibly hit closer to 73, 74.
Moose Young, Mandy jumping in here, you were saying that you might see rate hikes starting in New Zealand later on this year. At this stage, the interest rate markets are suggesting November would be the start to lift off the record low 0.25%, which would put it way ahead of, for example, Australia, the RBA, and of course the Fed in the United States. So what would that do in terms of the crosses like Kiwi against the Aussie and Kiwi against the dollar as well?
Yeah, I think that there will be some still some room for outperformance of the Kiwi relative to the the crosses. I mean, especially the Aussie and the US dollar. Having said that, I think both Australia and US is also inching towards the hawkish camp, although not quite there yet. But given the hawkish pivot that we've seen from the Fed meeting last month. And given that the latest RBA meeting seems to have turned somewhat moderately hawkish as well, that will also provide some support for the US dollar and the Aussie. So net-net, I think is the divergence is probably greater against the monetary policy laggards, which is the European Central Bank, the Swiss National Bank, as well as the Bank of Japan. And I see greatest room for Kiwi rally against these laggard currencies.